So this is my final topic of the day, final topic on the era of Kwonmunism. And as always, I will end it with a personal kind of experience or story. Lately, I've been having these dreams. I think it's because I'm sleeping longer hours than I have been, which makes sense because I'm currently unemployed. When I had a job, I definitely had less hours to sleep. But it's this dream in particular. I usually forget dreams. You know, sometimes I sleep, I wake up, I'm just like, I feel like I had a crazy dream, but I can't remember. That's like 90% of my dream, 95% maybe, of my, I'm putting a number to it, of my sleeping and dreaming experience. But this one stands out. I remember it still. Like, it's a crazy dream. It's not a nightmare per se, but it's not a good dream either. It just makes me think. It's a very thought-provoking dream. It's weird, right? And now I have to preface this dream with something about myself. I've been raised, I think I've said this about a million times in many other videos, but this fact is pretty much known now. If any of you have been watching any of my other videos, it's pretty, I've said it a lot that I'm a pastor's son. My dad is a Christian minister. My mom's a nurse who's deeply religious. And I've been raised, I had a Christian upbringing in my life, all my life still. And so up until I became 17, you know, people would ask me, like, what do you want to be in life? And my usual answer was, like, I want to be a pastor, or I want to be a missionary. That was my, like, life goal for, is it more than half, like, okay, I'm 25 now. More than half my life, actually. More than half my life, that was my life goal and dream, career goal, you know, working, doing my best to spread the word of God. Because that, you know, my reasoning behind that was that no one out there in the world should go to hell. And because I firmly believed in the Christian doctrine then that if you don't believe in Jesus as your one and only Savior, you're going to hell. So my mission in life has to be to prevent people from going to hell by learning about the love of Jesus Christ. So that's my upbringing. I eventually, ultimately, abandoned that upbringing after I turned 17 and a half. But the reason I preface this is because I want to talk about kind of the Christianity a bit, and religion in a way, because every religion that has an afterlife, I really like this. One of the YouTube videos, I was watching just a ton of YouTube videos the other day, and I watched this video, a short clip of Christopher Hutchinson, I believe is his name. I might be getting his name wrong, but the journalist, an outspoken atheist, British journalist. He talks about how religion has an obsession with or wanting to die. It can't wait. A religious person can't wait to die. That was his point. And it's a very powerful point if you come to think about it. And that's why for most of my life, I didn't fear death at all. It's honestly, because according to my belief, if I died, with my belief, I would be in heaven. And I would be in the happiest place ever, that is not possible on this earth. I'll be with my loving Jesus Savior. I mean, it's a pretty rosy picture. What is not possible in this world is going to happen after I die. So why should I fear death? In fact, death is a good thing. The only reason I'm here is to make sure that other people can have that kind of life after death. So it does make sense. I mean, every religion kind of promotes death in a way. Christianity certainly, because you get to go to heaven. And every religion that has an afterlife, places martyrdom as like one of its greatest, you know, virtues, and greatest heroes are martyrs. Christianity could not have been expanded without martyrs, you know. Islam, certainly, martyrdom is a big aspect of it, you know, people. And I was, in Japan, Buddhist monks, when they fought wars and stuff, they were promised, you know, heavenly life after death if they die virtuously and for the glory. So it's a powerful point that religion is obsessed with the idea of welcoming death. It's a very, you know, I don't want to say this way because I know it'll be offensive to a lot of you people who are religious, but it is a death-driven philosophy, in a way. I talk about this to preface that all this time, even up till maybe now, I'm not afraid of death. I haven't been. Like, I never really gave death too much a thought, like, to me. Like, I was like, yeah, but by, like, if somebody came into my room and pointed a gun to my head, and, you know, whatever, it wouldn't, like, it would be terrifying, okay, sure, but, like, if I die from that, like, I wouldn't, it's not, you know what I mean? Like, it's not that I don't fear it. I've been conditioned, I've been trained, I've been brought up my life to not fear death. That's the preface. Here's the dream. In my dream, I'm with a group of people. We're in an amusement park. I don't really know these groups of people. They seem familiar. The whole dream feels so surreal. You know, one of those dreams where, because there are certain types of dreams. There are types of dreams where it's just like, this, you wake up and it's like, that dream feels so real. Like, oh my God. Like, and then sometime later, you're talking with your friends like, hey, remember when this happened? And your friend is like, that never happened, dude. Oh, crap, that was your dream. There is those types of dreams where the dream feels so real. This wasn't that type of dream. It didn't feel so real. It felt surreal. Felt kind of not real, but real at the same time. Like, it's like I feel like I'm in a dream, but I feel like this is me right now in that dream. That's my feeling right now. So I'm with this group of people. They seem familiar, but I don't really know any of them. I woke up and I'm just like, I don't know who I was with. I was with a group of people. They felt like friends, but I can't really connect any of the faces to any names or vice versa. We're in the amusement park. It's a really crazy, weird, creepy amusement park. It feels kind of dead except for us. There's some kind of music in the background. There is like a carnival out there. And one of my friends like, hey, let's go on that ride. So I get on this ride. It's one of the most crazy, it's a crazy ride because what it does is it forces you, the ride goes backwards. So it starts here and it goes like this. I'm like, whoa, right? And then once it stops, it jolts and then jolts forward. Every time it jolts forward, there's this crazy rattling noise. Like there's all these noise. I'm like, what's going on? And the noise, I start realizing after like 5 seconds in the dream, it's 5 seconds. I don't know how long it is in real world because I'm not awake at this time. In 5 seconds, I like realize these are the sound of gunshots. These are machine gun bullets that are being fired. And so everyone is like ducking their head. The ride is jolting back and down. And then I realize this ride is pretty much, these are turrets over here. This is the ride that's going back and forth like this. Every time it jolts forward, machine gun fire. The goal of this ride is to survive the onslaught of machine gun fire. What the fuck? Now I'm just realizing like this isn't real. This isn't real. I'm dreaming. This isn't real. I'm feeling like that in the dream, but I'm not awake yet. It does this 5 times. On the 5th time, a bullet pierces this hand. And I don't know, it feels weird. It doesn't feel like pain, but it definitely feels like it doesn't feel good. And at that moment, I'm just like, that's when my heart starts pounding in the dream. I don't know if it was actually pounding in real life. My heart starts pounding, and I get this thought like, I'm going to die. I'm going to die. Oh my God, I'm going to die. I don't want, and this is where I felt terrified. I didn't want to die. Like, I don't want to die. I don't want to die. Please let me survive. Please let me survive. And then the ride ends. And I'm bleeding. And I get out. And my friends are all laughing. And we're going out. So, and they're like, let's go watch the movies in that ride. And I'm just walking along with them. And then I'm feeling this weird sensation because there's a hole in my hand and I'm bleeding. Okay, it's not pain, but it's just weird, and my heart is thumping. And I'm just like, I'm not dead. I'm not dead. I'm not dead. And then I woke up. That's really weird, because after that dream, that felt like that left such an imprint in my head, and I was just like, holy crap, I don't fear, I fear death. That was just terrifying. I did not want to die in that dream. And I woke up, I'm just like, I don't ever want to die. Like, after that dream, death as a concept is just terrifying to me. It is so weird that that dream was able to have that kind of mark on me when all my life, pretty much, I've been conditioned, socially conditioned, to never fear death. In fact, to accept death and to welcome death because it will lead to paradise in heaven. Maybe it's because I'm no longer a Christian that I have this fear. I don't know. What I do know is that dream was a hell of a dream. And I don't know what to think about that dream, honestly. It's one of the strangest dreams I've ever had. I'm amazed that I actually remember the dream because, like I said, most of the dreams I have, I don't remember. I mean, there are some dreams I do remember. I do have some crazy dreams. There's one, you know, cliche dream I've had. There's definitely more dreams to talk about. But this dream by far, which I had 3 weeks ago, it's a recent dream. This dream by far is the craziest dream I've ever had in my life. And I'll end the Hour of Communism with that. Hopefully, you have now become more communist than you were an hour ago. Cheers.